This is a short video on how to come out successful in the CKA exam by Linux Foundation. I recently became a CKA certified Kubernetes administrator, and I would just like to publish this video to help out folks who may be interested in taking this exam and come out successful. So I in fact took up this exam, or registered for this exam, at least a year ago, and in my second attempt I passed this exam. And before we go further in how to crack this test, I would like to first express my heartfelt thanks to Unshad Munambeth of Code Cloud. So all their lectures and practical exercises were really helpful in understanding Kubernetes. So to start with, I took up Kubernetes courses from some other firms, but they didn't give me that much of confidence. They made me feel inferior, and I was really skeptical on writing this Kubernetes exam. Then one of my friends introduced me to this course, and I also searched in Udemy and found this Code Cloud, and a lot of folks endorsed this course, so which made me feel that I should take up this course. So I took up this course last year, and really after some, in between I took some break, so I was not really practicing. But afterwards, from I would say from July, August, I started again my preparation, and it was really tough. And I wanted to really understand Kubernetes instead of just focusing on the exam. I just wanted to be technically really sound. So I tried to create a cluster on my own on my laptop with Vagrant. So I took it both the hard way and the Kubeadm way, just to understand the various concepts. Probably since I tried to create it on my own, so it took me more time to prepare, but it gave me some insight into what a Kubernetes cluster is really is. And I was able to create a cluster and make it run, and then took the kubeadmin, create a cluster with the kubeadmin tool. That also was very helpful, and really gave me the confidence on taking a backup of cluster, restoring the cluster, etc. And coming back to the exam, what I would suggest to all prospective students is to go through all the concepts and exercises thoroughly. There is no way you should leave some portion like, okay, I'll skip this topic, I will manage. It's not easy. Because in, for example, when I was an engineer, in our exams, we would say that we have 8 questions, out of which 5 questions we need to write properly. So we can skip one topic, so at least we'll still have 7 questions, out of which we can choose 5. But there the pass mark was only 50. But here in this case, for Kubernetes, it is higher. So there is no way you can afford to skip a topic and still hope to come out successful. So do study all the topics and give a lot of stress on the EDC, backup, restore. Try to go through all the tough topics, network policies, multiple containers and deployments, replica sets, to name a few, and also taints and tolerations, volumes. So a lot of tough topics are there. So you need to be thorough in them, and also expect the unexpected. So that also you need to be aware. That comes only with practice. So I cannot give you what are the questions that are being asked, but they can give you the topics that are being covered in this course. So all these important topics, don't ever leave them. It's not going to help you. So prepare well and go through this Kubernetes documentation thoroughly. That is very, very important, because in the exam, you can refer to the documentation. So you need to know, unless you are you know what the documentation is, it's very difficult to again search and then again find the topic. So, you know, it's like an open book exam, but time is only limited, only 2 hours you have to complete the exam. So you need to be really good in searching for a particular item that you want in the Kubernetes documentation. So please keep that in mind and search in the documentation. So you should be thorough in the documentation, know various topics. And some of my friends who had succeeded in exam, when I asked them what they did to prepare, they said they wrote at least 6 times. They wrote all this, they practiced all these exercises in this course by Nishad Munambeth. So you can also do that. And also there are 4 exams, the lightning labs and practice exams. So you practice them thoroughly so that you can come out successful. But in my case, additionally, I also registered for the CCAD course also with Munshad Munambeth. That was very useful in understanding the background. Plus, the exercises that he has in CCAD, they are tougher than, I would say, in case of what CK he is offering. So if you do those exercises and come out successful, you will have a really very good idea. So what I would suggest is, if you are doing CKA, please register for both the courses, CCAD and CK with Munshad Munambeth, and practice all the exercises thoroughly, then you can really hope for success. That is very important, because even though you may not write CCAD, CK is good enough, but to understand Kubernetes well, I would suggest that you register for both the courses and practice all the exams. Once again, I thank Munshad Munambeth, and thanks for watching this video. I hope you gained some knowledge about this, how to come out successful, and I wish you all the best.